Who of you guys cries the most?
Anthony Broski.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it you?
Yes.
He's like, he's
that's a little bit of a surprise.
Every interview, really? Every episode.
Yeah.
I'm very sensitive.
But
if
you.
I'm not super caffeinated, especially, my guard is down and I can give a good snot cry.
Who typically gets the most emotional over hero transformations?
Oh, who could it be?
Why does kindness make me so emotional?
Before he gave the vision, he already made provisions because he knew you guys would wind up together. Even before you were formed in your mother's womb, he knew you. I'm thankful. Oh, come here, Anthony. Anthony. Oh, my baby. You continue to let God use you, baby. Food is a way to the heart and, more importantly, the soul. You keep feeding the soul, people, okay?
He's like my grade school best friend.
Yeah.
Even though we just met a year ago.
Tanny, Benny, my dear sweet friend. I added Benny just now. I love him so much.
When I'm going through like a very difficult time and I sort of internalize and I tend to get really self-centered and make everything about me, then actually don't say anything.
I do nice things for you.
All the time.
Who is someone you guys go to for help within the group?
You. I go to Anthony.
What?
If I need advice or help, I always ask your opinion.
That made me emotional.
Yeah.
I get a lot of my fashion ideas from Tan, and I always try to check in with him and make sure that he doesn't get offended, because I think he really has amazing personal style and he's really pushed my envelope. So I love him. It's really hard to say anything mean about Tan.
Yeah, it's going to be so much fun.
Yes.
And you just up.
Oh, you're so sweet. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Anthony's too tired for that sort of validation right now.
When I'm tired, I'm really fucking emotional.
I just make sure I have a cup. Please have a cup.
Put your nose behind their ear. It's a magical spot, too.
He's looking at me like I'm crazy.
Can you scratch their tummy tums?
I don't think he's going to allow it.
So, Anthony, we call this the Corgi Parade.
Dorothy, Toto, I get the dog.
You're not afraid of salt. No, in a good way.
If you've got too much jelly in the belly, what you can do is layer up, make that eye dance, and then you'll distract from your weak spot.
Beam.
Corgi sighting in SLC. Get your flat ass over here and pay with me, I'm sorry.
I will choose to ignore the flat ass comment. In the year of a fluffy booty corgi, I understand the contrast. Corgis have booties, I don't.
And you just, I love a flashlight pointed directly at my face. It really showcases all my imperfections.
Don't die!
Can I ride your go-kart?
Yes, if you want.
Can I wear your helmet too, though?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't care.
Okay. There you go. Guys, I'm totally ready to drive the car the next time. I don't know what my fear has been. What are you doing with the horsey? Can I ride with you?
No, yeah, you can.
Grow up! You gotta break his Christmas stuff! Hurry!
I just learned patty cake.
Come on, join me, my...
She is a... Hi! My bad, go ahead. So good. It's called So Good. Remember, this is for the haters who said I wouldn't make it. Now it's selling platinum, and now you can't.
Full like old deco theater and little cafes, and we didn't get to stroll around too much, but...
Sorry.
Are you cutting me off?
Shut
up,
my bare feet.
Before I can see one of your testicles.
Before we start critiquing you or shaming you, we just want to say, like, I think it takes a tremendous amount of courage for you to volunteer yourself and your dad for a make better.
Just spread those legs.
It's very moist, this,
two consecutive sentences I've never heard before.
Yeah. Shall I use my fist to get it in? That's better.
Don't touch your eye or your arse, I would say, probably, either.
You love a good horse reference. Was it you?
Makes one horse
reference.
I think
reference. That's actually me and him have a very special bond. And he's if he's not with me, I get really blue and I call him a lot. But yeah, he really is one of the best people I know. And I got to know his family and his family are the best. He comes from real good stock. Like, he's an incredible person. You're okay. Yeah. And I love his outfit tonight.
I remember bits and pieces of some of that.
Yeah.
See, this is a lot of the confusion that was happening. She had to make a hard decision.
I love you right now.
I knew that you...
We're gonna help you, and nothing ever happens. And you guys... You guys...
She's a corgi and a beagle and...
Lacey, are you ready for some help from the Fab Five to get you ready for your new home?
Oh!
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, she licked his little nose.
Oh, that means yes.
Give Bobbers a kiss
you,
if you're ready. Give Bobbers a kiss if you're ready.
She loves them.
Yeah.
All right, get to work.
All right, get to work.
All right, come on, Angel.
I'm going to miss her.
All right, bye, guys. See you later.
I'm making dog treats.
I'm never coming back.
I love dogs. I love small dogs. I love big dogs, old dogs, young dogs, all dogs.
Lacey, you're an angel, and I love you, though we just met.
And then bananas for potassium, because I assume the dogs could benefit from potassium, just like humans. Lacey, can you please pick out which mold you would like your cookie in?
So I'm gonna put these three or four here, and you choose. Oh, was it the red?
Oh, I think she just touched the white one, actually. She literally just took her paw there. Yeah, that was very clear.
Good choice, good choice.
It was very clear. Puppers love treats. Puppers deserve love. And you should make treats from scratch whenever you can, because if humans deserve to engage in self-care like that, then dogs sure as hell do as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, food-wise, I know that there's a Mexican restaurant that you really like.
I also like to make sure I put a bed in, like, my bedroom and the living room, so that way she always knows she has her place.
Bobby, I think there's only one way to figure out if the bed is comfortable or
not. I think you should test it out.
Woo!
Aww.
So cute.
Angel. I think she's like, get out of my bed, man.
No, I think she likes it.
Yeah.
Oh.
When she was whispering sweet nothings earlier, she was talking about how much she loved CBGB and early New York punk in the 80s.
Oh God,
so I feel like this is a right fit.
Archie Brofsky and his bitch,
Lacey. Work, 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 work.
Oh, look at that little girl. Oh, do you feel cute? Did we do well? Do we do well? Are you ready to take on the world in your new home?
She is. Yeah. She loves what you picked out.
Your last ex-wife. Okay.
We still see each other every now and then.
Oh.
We have been.
Wait a second. Wait. Why did your face just twitch? Talk to me about that.
About Abby?
Yeah.
Well, I love Abby more than anything. I want to spend the rest of my life with her.
What's going on there?
She says she loves me. And I know I love her. Well, anyway.
Okay. Wait. No. No. Stop.
Okay.
So...
So what?
Why aren't you with her?
I don't know. You have to ask her why she's not with me.
I'm a romantic. The idea of bringing two people together who are meant to be, I think that would be really sweet.
She has always told me I'm the best man she's ever been with in her life.
The more that I'm getting to know him, I realize that there's a lot going on underneath. And he's very open about sharing that as well, which is such a gift.
I don't like being preached to. Just like, you just be an honest version of yourself. I know we've said it a lot, but that's what it boils down to. If you're like a nerdy person, be the nerdy person, because they're gonna figure it out on the first date anyway. Fake smells bad. It's nice to have a little like artistically directed, but Tinder is supposed to be an honest representation of who you are as a person, not an edited other social media.
No one needs to think that Annie Leibovitz took your pictures, honey. Right. It's okay.
But if you can get Annie Leibovitz, I mean, she takes some fantastic photos.
I mean, no one needs to go through the pages of Vanity Fair when they're going through your Tinder. Like, they just want to know you and your vibe, you know.
Just be real. With good lighting.
My husband finds me attractive, and he finds me sexy, and we keep that romance alive. And if there's something about me that he does not find attractive, I'm going to change
Take
it
a little
you.
Bit of each, and we have a thing called compromise.
Yes, that's what it is.
I'd say less inspired me, but just more, I think, offered a glimpse into the understanding of how she was raised. I think Pretty Hurts is like a really deep song that really hit me in a very profound way the first time that I heard it, so I would say that one.
Boy.
Is that your jeans, Anne?
No, Tanny, it must be Walter.
No.
Tanny, it's Walter.
Take them off. I'm telling you it's your jeans. Get up, I'm going to solve the problem for you. Take your jeans off.
Everyone likes to humiliate Anthony.
When we film Queer Eye, we're not in our own homes, and it's really important for me to feel like it's a home, and I love plants. So I spent like a full week's pay on just filling the place with plants, and I had Star Wars and G.I. Joe figurines everywhere.
It was so weird. It was so weird.
So he walks into my apartment and sits on the furniture, and I like light a candle, and then I'm like, fuck, this feels too sexy. And then I looked and I was like, no, but there's like literal like figurines, like we're good. And then I made a cup of tea, and I think we were both tired, and we had our guard down, and we just...
For four hours. Sat and talked. It got to like 3 o'clock in the morning, and I was like, okay, we have to leave. We've got to shoot tomorrow morning.
And I think I shared more with you that night than I have with anybody.
Me too. And then as we were leaving, I gave him a hug, and I was like, I think you might be my new favorite person. You were like, yeah, same. And then we've been inseparable ever since.
Yeah.